So yesterday I also showed this, that we can use these containers to not only ship our code, but also ship the exact server. I literally could run different versions of a framework on the same VM, no big deal, because I can containerize them. All my environment variables can go in here. Any security settings, everything unique to that part of the app can go in the container. So how would you run Angular then on a real server? Like, you've done ng-serve, which I love, and then you're like, hey, it works, I'm good to go, but I actually want to run it for real on whatever your choice is. So what if we want to get Angular running? Well, one way to do this is we make a custom Docker file. And what we do with the Docker file then is we, in the Docker file instructions, we copy in the dist folder into the image. That adds it to this chocolate cake. So imagine at the top of the chocolate cake layer, that's my code. But everything under is like the Nginx instructions and environment variables, stuff like that I might need. OK, then we build it to make an image. Now we take the image, and then we're going to run it. So when you do, I won't run it because I'm not in the right folder. But if I do an ng build, there's a dash DOP, delete output path, false. Now what that'll do is now when we build, instead of deleting the dist folder every time, it'll keep it, so now my volume doesn't break, my connection to the container doesn't break. And then every time we build, it just updates the files. Now here's how you build. So the way this works is you're going to set up a repository. So mine is just Dan Wahlin up on Docker Hub or AWS or Azure or whatever it may be. You're then going to name the image that you want to make. In this case, I just called it ng-app. And you're going to give it a tag. You don't have to tag it, but you should with a version. Because then you can actually, you literally could run version 1, version 1.1, version 1.2 at the same time. I don't know why you would, but you could in production, which is actually kind of cool. Or you can roll back easier as well. Okay, then to run it, we do the exact same thing, but no volume this time, because the code is in the container now, as we copied it. And now I have my same exact thing I'm running with that tag there. So let's talk more about this whole build process then. What if you just want to set up a CI/CD type process that actually uses containers? We can actually use containers for any build process. We could even use containers for testing processes, which is very, very cool, because what do you do with when you're done with the containers? Delete them. All right, so what they have in Docker is this is a newer concept. It's very cool, though. It's called multi-stage Docker files. It's the same thing we saw before. What you're going to do, though, is in the Docker file, you'll actually have multiple images that get built and containers that actually run. So the way it works is you could have a node image that actually does the build. But then the output from that, which would be the dist folder, could then be copied over to like an Nginx or an HA proxy or whatever you guys like to use for your actual runtime production or staging container. So a Docker Compose file takes other images you have out there and is like the conductor of an orchestra, says, all right, image one, fire up, image two, fire up, and it orchestrates bringing up a whole bunch or even just maybe two containers. And then you can run those images, convert them to running containers. How do you deploy these between environments then? Whether it's on-site or you want to move them up to Docker Hub or Azure or AWS or whatever you use, you know, what would you do? You would push the image or images up to your repository. Now, once you push, you're ready to go.